Hey guys, I'm gonna attempt to do IV fluids in 5 minutes or less. So why do we do IVs? We do them because patients may come in with dehydration or fluid overload, and we have to manage and get their fluids at a balanced level. So how do we start this process? First, IV fluids are considered another medication. So you're gonna do those six rites of med admin on whatever fluid is ordered. And then you're gonna before you start, the most important thing is that you want to listen to their lung sounds. So that is the most important vital that you wanna do, the most important assessment piece that you wanna do first. But you also wanna do a set of vitals, okay? Because if the patient is having dehydration, they might have a low BP and a high heart rate. You know, you wanna look at these components because that's important to what fluids you choose as well. So, and then you wanna avoid certain extremities. So if you have a patient come in that just had a mastectomy, you wanna avoid that same arm on the side of their mastectomy. Or if you have a patient with compromised skin, maybe it's a burn victim, you do not want to start an IV on that side either. It can, you know, it can cause more infections and it's just not worth it. So if you can. So now I'm going to talk about what are the two different types of IV solutions. There's colloid versus crystalloid. So what are colloids? Colloids, think like coal. They're just heavy. They're big. They're these giant molecules, right, that are usually of albumin, so protein. They could be blood products, but they're just these bigger molecules that don't usually dissolve or mix well with other solutions. So usually this is used when the patient can't tolerate crystalloids, which crystalloids are the main type of IV fluid that are these crystals that can mix easily. They can go in other solutions. And there's three types that we should know, which is isotonic, hypertonic, and hypotonic. So starting with isotonic. Isotonic is that normal saline, the 0.9. It's also lactated ringers. But what is it? So it is getting fluid in for a replacement. So with the cells, I'll stand over here. With the cells, they're not shrinking or they're not expanding. This is just to get the fluid in the body. So why do you want to use this? Patients that come in from emergency situations, maybe burns, shock, whatever, you need to get fluids in them because, you know, they're just not doing well. So this is what isotonic fluids are used for. It's replacing the fluid in the body. Hypertonic solutions. So hyper, just think of it as sucking the fluid out. You don't see this very often except in ICU patients. So maybe it's like a fluid overload. So with the hypertonic, it shrinks those cells. And the types of solutions that you use for hypertonic is going to be 5% dextrose and normal saline. And finally, hypotonic, I put the giant O because it expands the cells. Hypotonic is sucking that fluid in to expand these cells. So you're gonna have to use this on patients that are having, you know, like, you know, dehydration or hypertonic dehydration, I should say, DKA, gastric fluid loss, and this type of solution is also gonna be 1/2 normal saline. And so these are the three types. Again, isotonic, getting fluid in for replacement. Hypertonic, it sucks that fluid out. And then hypotonic, it's sucking that fluid in to get the cells to expand. And so what are the complications with IVs? We have first phlebitis. Phlebitis is that red streak, right, that you see on the skin, and it's at the insertion site. So what are you gonna do? With all three of these, the first thing you're gonna do is always discontinue the IV. But with phlebitis, you're going to also give the patient a warm compress. Infiltration, that is the seeping of the fluid out into the tissue. So you're gonna see a lot of swelling. The patient might say they're having coolness at the site. They might have pain. So again, you wanna discontinue and give a warm compress. And finally, extravasation, which is where there's a medication that is seeping out, but this medication is going to be more harmful to the tissue, so like potassium. So you're going to see a lot of redness, necrosis. It's literally killing those tissue cells, pain. So what you're going to do here with the treatment is that you're going to discontinue, obviously, the IV line, do a cold compress, and then give an antidote if there is one for the medication. Okay, I'm over 5 minutes.